Our top story this news day, and the fiscal cliff negotiations are again dominating Washington with a vote on the deal to avoid a crisis due in a couple of hours' time. The Senate has already passed the legislation, but so far it's faced deadlocks in the lower house, with Republicans wanting to add amendments. For more, we're joined by Dr. David Smith, a lecturer in American politics and foreign policy at the US Studies Center. David, thanks for joining us again. How sure can we be that this will be a done deal within hours?
Look, we can't be sure. John Boehner has to be confident at this point. The fact that he's allowing it to go to an up and down vote shows that he believes it will pass. I mean, if it doesn't pass, this is probably the end of his speakership, because this would be definitive proof that he just can't control his own caucus. I think that it's likely that it will pass, but I certainly wouldn't say with any certainty that it will until the vote actually happens. Certainly there were some very disgruntled House Republicans this morning. The reports that Boehner actually quelled a conservative revolt within the House. But in the end, House Republicans are thinking about their own primaries that they're going to have to face in a couple of years' time, those that are coming back for the next session, and we just can't be entirely sure that this will actually pass.
So what were those key sticking points that those Republicans have been balking at?
Republicans say that all that is happening with this measure is that they're giving up a tax increase without getting any further spending cuts in return. Now, this isn't entirely true in the sense that part of the deals that have already been done have already implemented some spending cuts, but they believe that these don't go anywhere near far enough. And so they actually wanted to lock in some more spending cuts. Initially, the plan was, I think, to attach $385 billion in spending cuts to an amendment and then send that back to the Senate. But I think they got fairly definitive word that the Senate was never going to pass an amendment like that, so they had to just settle for this up and down vote. But this was really the sticking point, how much there would be in spending cuts. I think that the House Republican leadership has hopefully convinced a majority of its House members that once this tax issue is out of the way, then with the debt ceiling limit approaching, they'll actually be in a much better position to extract a lot of concessions on spending without tax even having to be considered as an issue. So I think that's what Republicans are waiting for.
We're clearly keeping a really close eye on this here in Australia. How significant is it to us and to global markets that a deal is struck?
I think that global markets aren't going to tolerate too many more crises like this without a resolution. Global markets were very patient during the debt ceiling negotiations last year. Even though US credit got downgraded, this didn't result in an interest rate jump on US Treasury bonds. They seem to have been fairly sanguine this time around. We're not seeing a lot of panic. All of this indicates that financial markets and creditors do ultimately have faith in the United States government to actually sort out these problems. But we don't know how many more times the US can actually kick the can down the road, as they are doing again this time. I mean, we're going to go through all of this again in a couple of months before markets actually really start to react badly and really start to punish the United States.
Dr. David Smith from the US Studies Center, we appreciate you bringing us up to date and giving us some analysis on this. We are going to be keeping a very close watch on the happenings in the House of Representatives over the next couple of hours, with a vote due in around 2 hours' time.